OpenAI has just launched the GPT 5.2 model, and it has been the talk of the town because of its amazing benchmarks. So in terms of coding, as you can see here, it's got 55% and Claude Opus has got 52%. And the main differentiation is in Arc AGI, GPT 5.2 comes around 52% and Claude Opus 4.5 has 37%. So in this video, we'll be comparing both these models by giving lot of testing prompts as well as screenshots of website and sending a resume trying to convert it into a portfolio website. So we are going to do multiple ways of testing coding. So the difference isn't going to be much because it's 55% and 52%, but still let's give it a try. So for this, I'm going to use OpenRouter, where we'll be having lot of APIs. So these are the models that I get for GPT 5.2, and this is the GPT 5.2 chat, which is like an instant model, and this is 5.2 Pro. So this one here is the GPT 5.2 as well as the thinking model. So this has around 400,000 context, and input is 1.75 per million and output is 14 per million. So this is going to be our model, and if I click on chat, so as you can see here, reasoning has been enabled by default. So apart from that, I'm just going with the default settings. So for Claude Opus, here the context looks like this, 200,000. So GPT 5.2 is higher, and when compared to the price also, GPT 5.2 has better pricing. So let's see the model performance. Here also, I'm just going with the same settings of both. So first, let's begin with inputting a screenshot of the website. So here I'm having Twitter's interface, okay? And the reason why I have chosen this particular site is because of the complexity of the site. So it has three major portions. One is this left pane, center pane, and the right pane. So left pane has a lot of icons of different sizes, and center pane also has lots of icons. See these icons, and different context. And the right pane also has different set of icons with different fonts, and two icons here also. So it's going to be crazy how well the models can understand this image and try recreating it. So let's begin now. So here they are already having an interactive app option. I'll just select it and put the prompt, and I'll just like add my image. Okay. So this is going to be my prompt. Replicate the image exactly using code. Make as much as features to work. So let's see what it gives for this. And I'm giving the exact same thing for Opus 4.5 also. So we have got the output, and if I click it, here we can see the thinking process of Claude Opus. So I really like how well it thinks. So here you can see, right, it just lists down all the components and then plans how to create it. So we have got the code over here, and it's in TypeScript. I'll click on preview, and this is the preview, and go to full screen. Okay, so it has implemented the icons really well. So I will also pull up the real image. So first let's begin with the right side pane. Okay, let's go pane by pane, and this looks perfect. This part is perfect. Today's news is perfect. Of course, it cannot generate the images. That's fine. It has replaced the images with some funny icons. That's absolutely fine. And even it has, you know, corrected the boldness of the title text as well as the subtext. So we can see this is bold and this is grayish. So in my opinion, it has done an amazing job over here. The only thing is, this icon is not like similar. We are having a white back shadow. That's not here, but that's fine. That's I won't complain on that. Next, let's see about the center pane. Over here, it looks really good, and here also the icon is not there. It's fine, and it has beautifully recreated this icon. So here you can see, right, perfectly has done that. And we are having a scroll, so we got some like extra stuff going on here. And I really like how it has created Elon Musk and Naval. Like, I guess these are people from Twitter, but this has only Sam Altman. So basically, like, it has figured out that these are the people who are going to be big in Twitter, and it has even like put some tweets related to that. So Elon Musk says future is going to be amazing, working on some incredible features. So that's quite good. And yep, the middle pane is also perfect. And another thing that it has done, it has like expanded all the icons that I have given. So here you can see, right, in this particular image, in the left pane, I have just given the icons. I didn't give it as the home, messages or stuff, but it has literally recreated everything like this. So I don't think it's functionality wise, it hasn't added any features or something. Maybe if I type something and post, it may post it. Yes, it does that. So if I just now try minimizing it. All right, now we got the icon. So it's also like quite responsive. That's a bonus thing. So in my opinion, it has done a tremendous job, like almost 95% plus. It has literally recreated the UI that I have sent it. So that's really stunning from Opus 4.5. So now let's see the output generated by GPT 5.2. And this is the thinking that it has done. And similar to that, it has generated a TypeScript file. So let's see the output. Okay. So this is the output. And obviously you can see a greater difference between the Opus 4.5 and GPT 5.2 over here. So it has literally created the right pane quite well. And apart from the right pane, I don't think like anything is matching over here. To an extent, it has created the middle pane also, but that's also completely different. Like, we don't have that proper alignment and stuff. So overall, what I would say is like it has generated around 60-70%, but in my opinion, Opus 4.5 literally like beats it over here. So now let's move on to the second prompt. Code a big bird using HTML, CSS, JavaScript. Show the side view of the bird flying in one single file. So this may seem to be a really easy prompt, but only few AI models have been able to like recreate this prompt. So I'm just going to like test it out if these models can do it. So we have got the output, and this one is going to be like a simple one. And even for this, Claude Opus has gave a detailed explanation. So let's see the output. I'll go to preview. And wow, that looks stunning. We have got the bird. I don't know what bird it is, to be honest. Like, it looks like a chicken, but blue in color. And the background looks amazing. We have got some, like, I don't know what it's called, like a pyramid structure. And the gradient looks so fictional. It doesn't look like a real gradient background, but it looks good. It has done the job. We got the side view of the bird, and the bird looks so realistic. I mean, this is just like HTML, CSS and JavaScript. It has done a tremendous job, to be honest. Just look at the eyes. Just look at the detailing in the eyes. It has like three different colors. That's really good. And how its legs, wings, everything moves. So, and let's see what GPT 5.2 has given. So as usual, GPT 5.2 has gone in depth in reasoning. And let's see the preview. And okay, we have got the bird that looks like a duck, and we got some like ways to switch it. We got the speed and the controls. I'm not going to lie, this looks really good. Like, the bird looks really, really realistic. It looks like a duck, and the eyes and everything. I mean, we didn't mention the type of the bird. It moreover looks like it's moving on the water, and it has this cool controls, the pace at which it moves, the pause, and like, I didn't ask for this, but it has gone to an extent and generated this. So now here I'm having a resume of a programmer. We can see the name, email, the technical skills and stuff. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to like input this resume, and this is going to be my prompt. Convert this resume into a portfolio website. Make it with awesome transition effects of images and color themes and scroll effects. So I'm literally giving like every possible thing that makes a website cool, and I'm just asking them to convert this resume into a portfolio site. So this is going to be like a really challenging one, because the previous things that we gave were so simple. Like, it was just a simple HTML and it was a single screenshot conversion, but this is going to be a full-fledged portfolio website. So we can see a clear difference, okay? So let's see what both these models gives. So we have got the output. Let me open it, and we got the thinking over here. Let's see inside this, and there is a lot of files and folders. Wow. Okay, I'm excited to see the output. This is from GPT 5.2, and wow, just look at this. We are having three different color themes of text. That looks stunning. Okay, let me just go through this. And we're also having a scroll bar, and the scroll bar color also changes. Just look at this on the top, right? So if I go to the end, it just goes off. And if I scroll up, it just goes like this. So let's talk. We're having the light theme and dark theme also. That looks super fancy. I really like how beautifully it has got the gradient, because this gradient looks totally matching. Okay, overall what I would say is a really great clean portfolio site, because it has literally done what we have asked to it. Okay, let's see what Opus has done. So Opus, as usual, has listed so much of things, and yep, okay, that's a lot of code again here too. So this is the output that we have got for Opus. So this also looks absolutely stunning, and we don't see a lot of options to customize the color. Like, that's what I like about GPT, okay? It just gives a bit of customization, even in that bird thing, right? It gave us an option to customize the speed and stuff, but this has also done a really great job, and I really love the theme, how consistent it has kept it. So as a conclusion, what I would say is both GPT 5.2 as well as Opus 4.5 are almost the same. Like, in certain prompts we could see Opus 4.5 performing better, and in certain prompts GPT 5.2 performs better with a bit of like customization options that comes over it. So basically it just depends upon your use case, which model that you are choosing, and do try it out. It's available in ChatGPT, and let me know in the comments what you think about it. Check the playlist of my channel, done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.